This episode, we're visiting one of the Amalfi Coast's most romantic towns, Ravello. Andiamo! Ravello is a town of 2,381 inhabitants, nicknamed the City of Music. It is also the home to Villa Cimbrone, Villa Rufolo, and the striking Oscar Niemeyer Auditorium. Perched on a hilltop more than 1,200 feet or 365 meters up, it's not located obviously by the sea. To get there, you need to deviate from the coastal road between Amalfi and Maiori and climb a few kilometers. The municipality of Ravello stands out from the other towns on the coast for its quieter atmosphere. Being further from the sea and the beaches, it's never crowded like neighboring Positano or Amalfi. Especially in the evening, there are much less tourists who wander through the narrow streets, giving it a much more intimate and romantic feel. The Basilica of Santa Maria Assunta and San Pantaleone is the main place of Catholic worship in Ravello. On the 10th of July 1918, Pope Benedict XV elevated the former cathedral to the rank of minor basilica. Piazza Centrale is the main square of Ravello. On this square is the Duomo, multiple cafes, shops, restaurants, an art gallery, and the entrance into Villa Rufolo. Villa Rufolo is a building which overlooks the cathedral in Piazza del Vescovado and whose initial layout dates back to the 13th century with extensive 19th century alterations. The villa is accessed through an arched opening in the entrance tower, where after a short avenue you reach a clearing on which the Torre Maggiore rises, which faces the bell tower of the Cathedral of Ravello and dominates the terraces both upper and lower, overlooking the Amalfi Coast and the Gulf of Salerno, which host extraordinary garden blooms most of the year. When it was built in the 13th century, Villa Rufolo was one of the largest and most luxurious villas on the Amalfi Coast. It was built by a wealthy merchant, and during the 14th century, banquets for kings and nobility were held here. Furthermore, the rooms of the villa have also recently been restored. They all overlook the gardens with their incredible positioning, and within often host exhibitions and events. to commemorate the visit of the famous German writer and composer Richard Wagner in 1880, who, in referring to his visit of the villa, exclaimed he found true inspiration. After visiting the villa's gardens, their beauty led to the composition of a major portion of his final opera, Parsifal. Years later, his gratitude towards the town of Ravello inspired a return of appreciation with the creation of a summer music festival in his honor. And with that, every year, the lower garden of the Villa Rufolo hosts the Ravello Festival with much public success. Ravello is the hidden treasure of the Amalfi Coast, overlooking Maiori and Minori, and it enjoys a wide panoramic view of the Tyrrhenian Sea and the Gulf of Salerno. Intricate details of the construction throughout the villa are absolutely breathtaking. Its villas and vistas have enchanted visitors for centuries. Famous authors, actors, composers, and artists have come here for refuge and inspiration. Virginia Woolf, Richard Wagner, Tennessee Williams, M.C. Escher, Joan Miró, Greta Garbo, and Jacqueline Kennedy are just a few of the people who are frequent visitors of the town. Villa Cimbrone is built on a rocky promontory overlooking the coast, with part of the structure now used as a luxury hotel. The area is largely occupied by a park adorned with statues, antiquities, fountains, and caves, as well as having an incredible terrace overlooking the Gulf of Salerno and the neighboring towns, considered one of the most evocative in the world. Inside the villa, again, there is currently a 5-star hotel, while the garden itself is open to the public throughout the year and can be visited for a fee. The hotel and its park are located in a pedestrian area, accessible via a panoramic road, alternating with stairs. Inside the hotel, there's also a runway for takeoff and landing of helicopters. To get to the Infinity Terrace, you will stroll along the Avenue of Immensity, or the Viale dell'Immenso, walking under a pergola where wisteria bloom during the springtime. From the walkway, there are paths that lead deeper into the gardens, and it's well worth your time to visit these as well. Fountains and statues can be found throughout the gardens, giving the most serene experience possible. For most visitors, the highlight of Villa Cimbrone is the Infinity Terrace, or the Terrazza dell'Infinito. This terrace is lined with marble busts and has a stunning view out over the coast. Villa Cimbrone is a popular destination for luxury weddings and events. In fact, when I was visiting, they were just taking down items from the wedding the night before, and I was also lucky enough to see a proposal happening right on the terrace overlooking the sea. There's an incredible quote by noted American author and longtime resident Gore Vidal, who stated, 25 years ago, I was asked by an American magazine what was the most beautiful place that I'd ever seen in my travels, and I said the view from the Belvedere of the Villa Cimbrone on a bright winter's day when the sky and the sea were each so vividly blue that it was not possible to tell one from the other. You can also shop for ceramics, limoncello, art, and other souvenirs around Piazza Centrale and on the streets extending off of the square. I hope you all really enjoyed this dreamlike tour through the stunning town of Ravello. Until next time, alla prossima! Did you enjoy this episode? Please hit the like button and subscribe to be in the know for future episodes.